Ansu Fati is one of Barcelona's most talented youngsters at the moment. He's already scored for the club in La Liga, and he's basically a part of the first team now, which makes it a bit insane that he wasn't on FIFA 20 up until a few days ago. Yes guys, finally, EA dropped a new update, which means Ansu Fati is finally officially in FIFA 20. If you're on the PC version of FIFA 20, you can just update your squads and you will have Ansu Fati on your game, but on console, I guess you'll have to wait a few days more, so expect to have Ansu Fati on FIFA 20 if you're on PS4 or Xbox very soon. But I'm on the PC version, and that's why on your screen you can officially see Ansu Fati on the game. Alright, now you guys know how much I love this kid as a Barcelona fan, and that's why I wanted to test him out in career mode. So, we're gonna be simulating through seasons to get him to his max potential, which I believe is 90, and we'll be seeing how he performs in game. So, that should be a lot of fun. So basically, today's video is going to be an Ansu Fati growth test. If you guys are hyped to get Ansu Fati in your career mode, make sure to show your support on this one by dropping a like on the video. If you are new around here, subscribe for daily FIFA 20 career mode videos. Alright, so let's get this one underway. First up, let's take a look at the stats EA have given the 17-year-old. So he's 5'10", he can play on the left or on the right. EA have given him the left wing and right wing positions. We all know he's right-footed, but look at this, guys. EA have given him a 4-star weak foot and a 4-star skill move. That is actually brilliant because he'll be so overpowered once he's, of course, at his max potential, because a 4-star weak foot and a 4-star skill move is really, really good on FIFA. Medium attacking work rate, medium defensive work rate, not bad. Won't lie, guys, he's been given some really, really good stats. 87 pace, 69 shooting, 67 passing, 72 dribbling, 26 defending and 45 physical. Let's take a detailed look at his stats now. His aggression is pretty terrible. Composure 66, not too bad. Vision 66, could be better. Acceleration 89 is brilliant. 81 agility, could probably be better. 79 balance, not too convincing, but 85 sprint speed is actually pretty good. On the ball, he's got some good attributes. 70 ball control for a 71 rated player is decent. 72 finishing is actually brilliant. 71 dribbling, not too bad. 74 penalties. I haven't seen him take a penalty, so I'm not too sure why that stat is so high for him. 71 shot passing as well. Now, EA have given him some really good traits. Outside foot shot, that should be interesting. Speed dribbler and a technical dribbler, so he's gonna be good on the ball, that's for sure. I've gone handed to EA for adding Ansu Fati as soon as he turns 17 to FIFA. I've been really wanting to see this kid on FIFA because he's been performing so well in real life whenever given the opportunity, and career mode is all about youngsters, so to have him on FIFA 20 career mode is just brilliant. Saying that, let's now hop on to career mode, sim through a few seasons, and see how this guy progresses. This is how Ansu Fati looks in game. A bit disappointing that he does not have a game face. Hopefully in the future FIFAs he will get one, because I'm sure he's going to do bits for Barcelona, and with that, he's definitely going to get a game face. So, we're going to be simming through seasons. We're not going to be training him at all, because that'll just take way too much time, and I'm not going to be changing the lineups or anything. We're just going to directly simulate through seasons, and ultimately we'll check how much time and at what overall does Ansu Fati peak. Alright guys, simulating through the first season, I'm hoping we don't get fired, because that would be a big fail. Okay, so after simulating through the first season, Ansu Fati went up by 3 ratings, which isn't all that bad. In fact, it's pretty good, from 71 to 74. And if you look at his stats, they've gone up pretty well, like acceleration up by 2, agility up by 3, balance up by 1, sprint speed increased as well, reactions up by 4, his strength went up by 3, composure went up by 3, and we know how important that stat is. Looking at his technical stats, ball control up by 5, dribbling up by 4, finishing up by 3, long shots up by 4 as well, shot passing up by 4. His stats have grown really well in this first season, but funnily enough, he's not gotten a single game to play. That's incredible. And also, I've disabled the Champions League for this simulation because it'll just slow down making the video and it doesn't really matter for this growth test. But there you go, Ansu Fati barely played a game but still went up by 3 ratings in the first season. So at the end of season 2, Ansu Fati continues his growth. He's gone up by 3 ratings once again, 74 to now a 77 rated player. Let's take a look at his stats now. Sprint speed up by 1, acceleration now is 93. His composure hasn't gone up, which is interesting. Vision up by 1, though, strength up by 1, but technically he's improved massively with ball control up to 77, crossing up to 72, dribbling up to 80, finishing up to 80 as well. Long shots have increased. He's done well this season, but the funny thing is, once again, he's barely got himself any game time this season. He's played zero games, that's right, zero in season 2 as well, which is a bit weird. Let's see if that changes in future seasons. Hopefully, this won't impact his growth. Things have gotten a bit interesting after season 3, because instead of going up by 3 ratings, Ansu Fati has just gone up by 2. He is now 79 rated, but the funny thing is, he's actually played quite a few games this season. 37 games, 12 goals and 1 assist, but he's only gone up by 2 ratings. That is a bit weird, but some of his stats have gone up massively. 98 acceleration, he's gone up to a 90 agility, 88 sprint speed. Man, at his peak, Ansu's going to be amazing on FIFA 20. If you look at his technical stats as well, his long shots up to 83, shot passing up to 81, shot power up to 73 as well. The guy's got some crazy good stats right now. So at the end of season 4, Ansu Fati's overall has gone up by 1. I was expecting more player growth from him, but 1 rating at the age of 20, I guess, isn't all that bad. He's still got a good 6 or 7 years to grow more in this game. So 79 to 80, if you look at his stats, they've gone up pretty well, to be honest. I don't know how it turns out to only a plus 1 overall boost. Acceleration maxed out at 99, agility now at 92, sprint speed up to a 91, vision up to 71 as well. His technical stats are increasing, finishing, dribbling all have gone up, long shots up to 85. The guy continues to increase in his stats. And if you look at his, you know, gameplay stats, 40 games played, 8 goals, not bad in his 4th season at Barcelona. Now this is much better from Ansu Fati. End of season 5, he's managed to get up to an 82 rating. That's brilliant. Agility up to 95, sprint speed up to 92, composure going up as well. But it's the technical stats once again that take a massive leap. Dribbling up to 85, ball control, crossing, long shots up to 88, shot passing has gone up as well. Yes, no traits, which is a bit frustrating. I don't think as players increase in their overall, they don't get traits. So we won't see Ansu Fati with any new traits. But after 5 seasons in career mode, Ansu Fati, now 21 years old, he's 82 rated. So this is getting a bit weird now. End of season 6, Ansu Fati has just gone up by 1 rating. At this point of time, I expect him to go up more in his overall, but he's been a bit of a slow grower in this simulation, so that's a bit weird. He's gone up by 1 though, 83 rated right now at the age of 22. His stats though have increased pretty well. Agility up to 96, sprint speed gone up to a 96, composure up as well. Technical stats have gone up, like finishing up to 85, dribbling up to 86, shot passing up to 87. So there is a good increase in his stats, but he's still only 83 rated. I'm hoping he can touch 85, 86 very soon. Let's see what happens next season. Now that's what I'm talking about, guys. Ansu Fati is making some serious progress now. He's gone up to an 85 rating. This is what we want to see. Gone up by 2 overalls this season. End of season 7, if I'm not wrong. So fair play, Ansu Fati. 85 rated now. His stats are going up massively. Sprint speed almost maxed out. Agility as well. Reactions up to 79. Stamina going up as well. And his technical stats finishing up to 87. Shot passing has gone up. Volleys, heading, crossing as well. Good to see. 85 rated is pretty good at 23 years old. I think he can definitely hit his peak, which I guess is 90. He played 45 games this season, 19 goals and 4 assists. So we've simulated another season and Ansu Fati is at an 86 overall. He went up by 1 rating this season. A bit disappointing. Expected more growth from him this season. And by the way, we're at the end of season 8 and we're only simulating up to 10 seasons. So he's got 2 more seasons to try and hit his max potential. Let's see if that is possible. His stats though, some of them have maxed out already. Agility 99, sprint speed 99, reactions up to an 82 now. Also ball control up to 84, crossing up to 81. With training, you guys can make Ansu Fati literally 95 or 96 rating, in my opinion. Finishing up to 88, dribbling up to 88, shot passing up to 94. Let's see what he can do in these final 2 seasons. Okay, so more progress this season from Ansu Fati. 25 now. We could say that he is in his prime at the moment. 86 up to an 88 rating, which is great to see. Reactions have gone up. Strength up as well. Composure up by 2. Vision up by 2. Technical stats going up massively. Finishing up to a 90. Dribbling up to 90 as well. Basically, his stats... Oh, wait. Long shots up to 96. His stats have gone up really well this season. This is what I call growth. Ansu Fati now up to an 88. We've got 1 more season to simulate. I'm hoping he can touch that 90 mark. Stats-wise, Ansu Fati scored 35 times this season, 9 times in the Champions League. Insane. Here we are, guys. We've done it. We've simulated through 10 seasons in FIFA 20 career mode. It's taken me more than 4 hours, man. It's been ridiculous. But we are here now. Season 10. Time to see Ansu Fati in his prime. What's his overall going to be? Let's find out. And he has managed to reach his max potential, which is 90. Of course, if we would have trained him, he would have definitely gone up more in his overall through, of course, dynamic player potential and all. But after 10 seasons of normally simulating through career mode, Ansu Fati ends at a 90 rating, which is amazing, by the way. His stats have gone up pretty well this season. Vision up by 6 to 85. Composure up to 77. Reactions up as well. Technical stats going up pretty well as well. Finishing up to 92. Dribbling up to 91. Ball control up to 87. Crossing up to 83. Shot passing. Long shots all 99. Which is crazy, man. Ansu Fati has reached a 90 rating, which was expected. That was his peak. So he's managed to achieve his max potential. Now, stats-wise this season, 23 goals in 56 games. So this is Ansu Fati after 10 years. Of course, I'm not leaving you guys without some gameplay with Ansu Fati. So we're in the Champions League final up against Man City. Let's play this game and hopefully see a few goals from Ansu. The primary reason why this video took so long for me to record is because I had to constantly sign different players because some were getting unhappy, some's contracts were expiring. So ultimately, what you're seeing on your screen is a completely different Barca team with Mbappe, Sancho, De Jong, Arthur, Rodri, Junior Firpo playing as left back, John Stones, who's now 82 rated, De Ligt, who's 97 rated, Trent, Ter Stegen as well. De Jong is 97, by the way. Arthur and Rodri, 93 and 94 respectively. Mbappe has hit 99. That is just insane. On the bench, we've got some more players as well. Longley is unfortunately injured. Abel Ruiz, who's 88. Alenia, who's 82. But yeah, this is the team that can hopefully win us the Champions League. That's the City team we're facing. I'm really interested to see their lineup. They've got a lot of interesting players. Bernardo Silva still playing for them. They've got Sterling on the bench. A lot of youth players in there from the academy, I suppose. Saliba, the current Arsenal player, I suppose. Marquinhos. They've got Hakimi, Hudson-Odoi. An interesting team. A lot of players that I don't know because they're probably from the academy. Hudson-Odoi inside to Hakimi, who gets his first chance of the game, pushing forward. But thankfully, Ter Stegen, who's what, 35, 36 years old now, still makes the save. Corner for Man City as Hakimi with the header is scored. Wow, we're a goal down within 6 minutes. I mean, City players are probably really high rated now. That's why they're in the Champions League final. But Hakimi scoring a header from a corner, a bit frustrating to concede a goal like that in this game. So with a goal down, hopefully Ansu Fati can respond. Let's get Ansu Fati on the ball and just see what he's all about. He seems pretty agile, which he should be. He's got 99 agility, if I'm not wrong. So hopefully he can put that into good news. He feels pretty quick on the ball as well. He's got good passing and all that. I'm hoping we can score with him. Frenkie de Jong finds Rodri. In behind now to Ansu Fati. That is what you want to see. Here goes the Spaniard now. Ansu brings it back in. Kylian Mbappe shoots. That should have been 1-1. A brilliant play there from Ansu to lay it off to Mbappe. But Kylian couldn't convert that. It's a big block coming in from Marquinhos. Here's Kylian Mbappe now on the attack. Oh, Mbappe with the pace. Look at how quick he is. Releases Ansu Fati. Ansu brings it inside. Still Ansu tries to curl this one in, but I couldn't time it properly. Well, it goes wide. Releases Frenkie de Jong as now we go on the attack. Go on, Frenkie. Now it's Kylian Mbappe with the chance. Still Mbappe. Mbappe with a few stepovers brings it back inside to Junior Firpo of all players. Somehow his shot's blocked. Frenkie de Jong now. I'm trying to move the ball to the other side. It's Ansu Fati now on the attack. He's trying to get away from his man. Rodri. Frenkie de Jong. I have no idea what's going on, but City get it away. We're struggling in the attack. I'm going to release Kylian Mbappe. This should be brilliant for us. Here goes Mbappe. Kylian Mbappe shoots. Oh, the keeper makes a good save there. Mbappe, who's 99 rated, probably should have converted that halftime. So far, City with the lead. We've got to make some changes for that second half, man, because things aren't really working that well for even Ansu Fati. Let's change up the tactics a little bit by playing a narrow formation. You guys know this is my favorite formation in FIFA 20, so I'm hoping it works now. Fati playing as the right striker and Mbappe as the left striker. Releases this one for Arthur Melo. Now inside to Jadon Sancho. He is onside. Kylian Mbappe completely free. And that was brilliant football from us as we make it 1-1 against City. 99 rated Mbappe getting us the equalizer. Brilliant build-up play as well. Sancho got the ball in a good spot. All he had to do was lay it off for Mbappe. And then the goal came pretty easily after, with the killer pass to Sancho. Job done, 1-1 now. It's game on. Here goes Jadon Sancho now on the attack. Releases Ansu Fati. Can we finally see some action here from the Spaniard? Ansu Fati looks to bring it inside. Sends one down. Arthur with the chance. Come on. We really should have scored. The Ansu did brilliantly to create the opportunity. Sent one defender to the floor. Here's Arthur. Oh, gets fouled there. That's a terrible challenge on him. But Ansu gets the ball. Turns. Ansu Fati with the chance to win the game for us. Now it's Sancho. Sancho shoots and it's in. Jadon Sancho scores. As at the 88th minute, we've made it 2-1. Let's go. We get to see something from Ansu at least. An assist for the goal from Sancho. It was chaos in the City defense there. And somehow we managed to put the ball in the back of the net. Jadon Sancho scoring for us. Ansu Fati there did really well. Couldn't get the shot off properly. It hit his heels as well. Somehow we managed to pass it to Sancho and he did the rest. 2-1 Barcelona. And that's full time. We've managed to win the Champions League 10 seasons later in this career mode. We did it brilliantly. Mbappe, Sancho scoring for us. But most importantly, you guys got to see a bit of action from Ansu Fati. Hopefully you guys enjoy using him in your career mode. So 10 seasons later, Ansu Fati maxed out at a 90 potential. It's great to have him in FIFA 20, and hopefully soon he'll have a real face in FIFA as well. So with that, guys, I'm going to be ending off the video. Really hope you guys enjoyed this one. It took me hours to make. So if you guys could drop a like, that'd be brilliant. Subscribe if you are new around here, and I'll catch you guys next time for more FIFA 20 career mode content.